Hi students, I welcome you all to today's class. In previous class, we seen about lesson 1, Rikki Tikki Tavi. Who is Snog? Very interesting, isn't it? Let's get into the class. Shall we see who is Snog? Rikki Tikki asked to Drassy and his wife, who is Snog? Drassy and his wife only cowered down in the nest without answering. From the thick grass, at the foot of the bush, there came a low hiss, a horrid cold sound. It made Rikki Tikki jump back 2 clear feet. Then, inch by inch out of the grass, rose Snog, the big black cobra, with his hood spread out. He was 5 feet long from tongue to tail. When he had lifted 1/3 of himself off the ground, he stayed swaying gently to and fro. Snog looked at Rikki Tikki with the wicked snake's eyes that never changed their expression. "Who is Snog?" he said. "I am Snog. Look and be afraid." He spread out of his hood more and Rikki Tikki was afraid for a minute. A grown mongoose's duty in life was to fight and eat snakes. Snog knew that too. And at the bottom of his cold heart, he was afraid. "Well," said Rikki Tikki, and his tail began to flap up again. Rikki Tikki asked to the Snog, "Do you think it is right for you to eat fledglings out of your nest?" Snog said that, "You eat eggs. Why should not I eat birds?" Meanwhile, Drassy warned to Rikki Tikki, "Behind you! Look behind you!" Rikki Tikki Tavi did not waste time in looking. He jumped up in the air as high as he could go. And just under him whisked by the head of Nagina, Snog's wicked wife. She had crept up behind him as he was talking to kill him. Rikki Tikki heard her savage hiss as she missed and he came down her back. If he had been an old mongoose, he would have known that it was the right time to break her back with one bite. But Rikki Tikki was afraid of the terrible lashing return stroke of the cobra. He bit, but did not bite long enough. He jumped clear of the whisking tail, leaving Nagina torn and angry. Rikki Tikki felt his eyes growing red and hot. He chatted with Rag, but Snog and Nagina had disappeared into the grass. When a snake misses its stroke, it never says anything or give any sign of what it means to do next. Rikki Tikki did not follow them because he was not sure that he could manage 2 snakes at once. So he trotted off to the gravel path near the house and sat down to think. It was a serious matter for him. That's how Rikki Tikki had his experience in that bungalow. That's all the lesson, children. I will meet you next class. Stay home, stay safe. Bye, children.